This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, the War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. We're joined now by one of Mexico's most acclaimed singer-songwriters, the Grammy-winning Lila Downs. She just released her 10th album. It's called Salón, Lágrimas y Deseo. She dedicated it to strong women everywhere. Lila Downs is preparing for some of her first concerts in the United States since the election of President Donald Trump. Last year, she dedicated a new song titled The Demagogue to Trump. Part of the lyrics include the lines, "He's a bully, a salesman, selling fear and hate. Who do you think you are? No to that wall. I'm cutting all the hate and planting love." For Lila Downs, singing about politics is nothing new. She was born in Oaxaca in 1968. Her music's long been inspired by the sounds and struggles of indigenous people in Mexico. Lila Downs, it's an honor to have you here at Democracy Now!
It's an honor to be here. Thank you.
So, can you start off by talking about what inspired you to write a song about the U.S. President Donald Trump?
Oh, my goodness. Well, a lot of emotions. I think I was mainly concerned about Mexican-Americans and also Latin people going out and voting. And I think I was also aware of the fact that there was the KKK was in the picture somehow, and it really scared me. And I guess that I also felt fear the same way that I imagine a lot of racist people feel fear towards us. So I would say that it was a kind of a natural, instinctual response to hate, to insults towards, you know, beautiful cultures in Latin America that survive. And also, I felt really disappointed with people who are very ignorant about who we are and our beautiful history and rich cultures, because we are quite diverse past the border down south.
You know, not a lot of people thought he would win when he first announced 2 years ago in 2015 that he was running for president when he came down the escalator. And in that first presidential, you know, announcement, he talked about Mexicans as rapists. Do you remember where you were when you first became aware of him as a presidential candidate and what he was saying?
Oh, my goodness.
Not only about Mexicans as rapists, but about building the wall that Mexico would pay for?
Yeah. Well, I think that it was kind of like a monster creeping up. I mean, that's why I think I put that lyric in there, a monster creeping up from my deepest fears. I think I have devoted my life to write songs about very dark situations sometimes, about maquiladora women who work at the border, which is a pretty serious subject. I think that I was very insulted, but I wasn't surprised, maybe because, you know, I grew up in Minnesota part of my life, and I was aware of the fact there were a lot of people feeling a lot of things that I could see through their eyes but never dared say anything. So I guess it is like coming out of the closet in a way, you know, all this hate. Fear mainly, I think, and ignorance, of course.
Oh, by the way, President Trump just went to Iowa, where he did another campaign-style rally. Interestingly, the local paper, which is quite conservative, urged him not to be in Iowa, but to go back to Washington to govern, not to do campaigns. But in that speech that he gave this week, he talked about the wall, building it again, but he said he'd put solar panels on the wall so Mexico would have to pay less for it because they could generate electricity.
Oh, wow. Interesting addition.
So, why don't we go to you performing The Demagogue?
At the edge of the world where the factories are, there's a burning of hatred that's crossing the lines. There's a blue-eyed devil man. He's king of the world. He's bullying
think you are. He plays us with his hate, turns man against man, but it's really not a game. And I pray to the ancestors' love, do not be fooled by this man's foolish talk. The serpent woke again in different times and places. There's a burning cross leading the mob, people in chains. He's a quack circus act creeping from the past. He's the symbol of the monster we no longer want to be. What we used to be. Earth trembles with his names, Mussolini, Adolf Hitler, Pinochet. No respect for woman, no respect for race, no respect for anything that lives, the human race. But he cannot buy our soul. No a ese muro voy cortando el odio.
That's The Demagogue, performed by Lila Downs, the many-time Grammy Award-winning Mexican singer who's performing in the United States and has just released her 10th album. So let's talk about your growing up, because you grew up both in the United States and in Mexico. You were born in Oaxaca. Talk about your family and your inspirations and what it meant to live here and how you felt.
Well, I think that one of the issues in my life has always been defining myself. And, you know, some people call me Mexican, but I consider myself Native American, Oaxacan, Mexican-American, Chicana, and a citizen of the world.
Your father from here, your mother from Oaxaca?
Yes, my father was Scottish-American. And my mother is a Mixtec Indian from Oaxaca.
How did they meet?
My mother was singing in a little bar, or actually she says it was a cafeteria. And my father's version was more romantic and bohemian. And yeah, he was working on a documentary studying the blue-winged teal. He was also a biologist that migrates from Canada to the Yucatan Peninsula. And he went through Mexico City and saw this woman singing and dancing. And
in this cafeteria, not to be confused with bar.
Yes, of course. And he fell in love, and he got divorced. I have half sisters and brother here in the U.S. And you know, then continued the story and finally looked them up later on, you know, in my life.
1968, you were born in Oaxaca. When did you move to the United States?
I actually was very fortunate and had the privilege of being in the U.S. 1 year and then another year in Oaxaca, in a little village in Oaxaca called Tlaxiaco, and then going to Minnesota and then coming back and like that. That was my elementary and also high school. Then I went to L.A., moved to L.A. for a little while, and then at the university, I returned to University of Minnesota. So I always had that.
To study anthropology?
Yes, to study, well, first voice, and then, dropped out, followed the Grateful Dead for a while.
Why the Grateful Dead? Well, a lot of deadheads are now saying, what do you mean, why the Grateful Dead?
But, well, you know, I was attracted to the title of their band, firstly, but then kind of wanted to really drop out of society and figure myself out. Like I said, because this has been my journey, and through music I've been able to figure myself out in some ways, I guess.
Did you find yourself at a point growing up, when you were in the United States, of shunning your Mexican culture?
Definitely. Definitely. Like I said, Minnesota was a very Nordic kind of a place. There were few Latin people in St. Paul, I remember. But definitely people would not talk about the racism, but you felt it there. Of course, this also happens in Mexico, because as you may know, Mexican nationals, if we have dark skin and black hair, generally we have Indian or African origin or mix in some place. And some of us can trace back our heritage to some Indian group. There are 64 Native American groups in Mexico and languages. And the Mayan language and the Nahuatl language, or the language of the Aztecs, are spoken by millions of people today.
And what about Mixtec, your mother's?
My mother's language is spoken by probably 400,000 to 500,000 people, many of whom are living in California and Oregon and Washington, work in the fields.
Did you reject your mother as you rejected your culture for a time?
I did. I did. I was studying classical music, and I remember feeling rejected in a way by the European tradition, I guess. You know, I was singing songs in French and German and Italian. And I thought, wait a minute, you know, I'm really, something is going on here. I would look at myself in the mirror. I used to bleach my hair blonde, and it wasn't me. And during the Grateful Dead following, I let my roots come out, and that was the beginning of this this journey, looking for my Native American roots, which are also very much in denial in Mexico and many parts of Latin America. We're still working on that one as well.
And so how was that year following the Grateful Dead? In the end, how did you discover yourself?
Well, I wish I could say, you know, it was from one night to the other. But life doesn't work that way. I think that it's about lessons and steps, and certainly music, I think, is the kind of magic that opens the soul in a way that you can connect with and have empathy and learn about things that are different to yourself. And in that, I think I have been fortunate to find examples of amazing women in my life. My mother taught me to sit and observe other women. And this was one of the greatest lessons in my life, I think, because this way I have connected to women from, you know, North America to the tip of Patagonia, and found out the beautiful way that we create food out of corn, for example. And this is a uniting symbol. Of course, corn means something very different here in the U.S. and what it has become, which is also a very interesting issue. People have taken control of something that is very sacred to us in Native America. And I mean America, the continent. And I think that my mother would say, sit and listen to the women who are with their tenates, which are these beautiful baskets, and they sit on the floor in the markets of Mexico, and just watch them And so I wrote a song about this, and I named my son Shilonin, which is a tender corn, because the moment of tender corn in the Mixtec language, for example, is the most precious version of beauty. And so there are these poetic things that we can learn from and that we inherit naturally. It's all a matter of, you know, reading a little bit about our stories and hopefully listening to the music that brings us these stories.
You talk about being inspired by your mother and her telling you to watch women. Yes. Your title song on your latest album is Peligrosa, is Dangerous Woman.
Yes.
Talk about this.
You know, it's very interesting because when people come up to me and say, oh, so now you're peligrosa, now you're dangerous, the way women ask the question is very different to the way men will ask it. And some men feel the aggression, and they're like, oh, so you're one of these feminists? And so I answer, well, if it weren't for feminism, I would not be here talking to you freely. I could not wear my jeans. I could not come and speak to you freely. I would have to ask permission from my husband. I couldn't vote. And, you know, it's a very good subject to bring up and talk about. So I love that about our music. And I think generally I do songs and I write songs based, and I choose classic songs based on that possibility in order to discuss these songs and also perform them and make people, hopefully, make them feel. What does it mean to have a dangerous woman? Is it because she thinks? Is it because she has opinions? Is it because she is independent and beautiful, maybe?
Are there particular women you think of when you sing Peligrosa?
Yes. I think of women who are very strong, who have maybe been in violent situations, painful situations, and in spite of this, they get up, and even though they're limping, they get up and they love. They love in spite of all that. And that is just amazing to me.
Let's go to Lila Downs, the Grammy Award-winning Mexican singer, singing Peligrosa, Dangerous Woman.
Dangerous. They say I'm dangerous woman because I think, I have opinions, I vote. And I'm perceiving something that feels like love. But I'm not sure it's love.
Dicen que yo soy peligrosa, que yo soy dolorosa, porque quiero vivir así. Dicen que yo soy enjundiosa, caprichosa y hermosa, que no puedo seguir así. Te digo que sí soy peligrosa, que sí soy dolorosa, porque te quiero para mí. Sí soy intrépida, costosa, que quiero lo bueno para mí. No sé lo que siento contigo, pero todo lo quiero contigo y todo lo puedo. No sé, sé qué será sin eso que tienes tú. Thank you. que si soy peligrosa, que si soy dolorosa, porque te quiero para mí. Si soy afanosa, intrépida, costosa, que quiero lo bueno para mí, no sé lo que siento contigo, pero
Peligrosa, Dangerous Woman, sung by Lila Downs. It's the title song of her just-released 10th album, Salón, Lágrimas y Deseo. Talk about that in English. And when you choose to sing songs in English and in Spanish, but what your song—what the record title means.
Mm-hmm. Well, it refers to a beautiful era in music, I think. Bolero is a musical tradition that comes from Cuba but is shared in all parts of Latin America and has a particular style when it's performed in Colombia and, of course, in Mexico as well. The famous trios like Los Panchos, Los Tres Diamantes are very beloved from that era. We would say it's probably the golden era of music. And for dance, you would go to these beautiful salones, or saloon-type places where you could have some drinks, but mainly it was about the dance. And the formality of the dance was women would have their fan and rest in a certain part of the song. The danzón is a very important genre as well during this period, and beautiful instrumentation. Afro-Caribbean music makes a very important connection with this music in Mexico, and also the standard, the North American standard, makes an influence. The chords are more sophisticated. It's more about the people coming to the city and changing in their vision. And I think I always wanted to do these songs, but my mother kind of really was not very, pro-bolero, pro-sophisticated. She was like, no, Lila, you know, if you want to sing Mexican music, it's got to be the rancheras, which are the country songs of Mexico. And I would say they're probably the more soulful songs, which that was my first influence, of course.
Speaking of powerful women, one of the ways your music got known in the United States was through a film, through a very difficult time in U.S. history, right around the downing of the towers, September 11, 2001. You were part of the making of the film Frida, about Frida Kahlo, the great Mexican artist.
Yes.
Can you talk about that project?
Yeah. We were very excited to be part of it. Of course, I studied symbolism and anthropology, and that's why textiles are very important to me. But I did not know about Frida Kahlo, which is an interesting kind of feminist issue, because in school, they teach you about Diego Rivera in my generation. But you never
hear. The great Mexican muralist.
Yes, the great Mexican muralist, her husband. But they never talk about Frida Kahlo. I mean, I imagine nowadays they do, I hope. But in any case, I discovered her in college, and I thought, wow, this is amazing. You know, my mouth was open. I then discovered she was Zapotec. Her mother was Zapotec, which is this textile that I'm wearing is from this region of the Zapotec, off the coast of Oaxaca, Mexico. And Julie Taymor invited us. We were living in New York City at that time, and I guess that Elliot Goldenthal, her husband, who's the musical director of the music in the film, walks into Virgin Music and discovers our music. And it was quite a gift for us because, in a way, we kind of didn't have to, you know, prostitute ourselves that much, you know? Musicians, I think we have that side. I mean, all of us, I guess, in a way, right? When you need a gig, you need to go and out and get it. And so we got lucky because we get to do music that has conviction and meaning and also be in the movie about Frida Kahlo.
Can you introduce this? We're going to play a clip of the film where you're singing. Can you introduce this scene to us?
Sure. There's a beautiful scene that's at the end of the film where she is on her deathbed. And I am singing to her. And I remember making the scene was really intense because we were all crying and crying and crying. To see her die was a big one, and the mariachi is singing there with me, and it's a beautiful scene paying a tribute to this great feminist Mexican painter.
Let's go to Lila Downs singing in the film Frida.
To Frida.
Salías del templo un día llorona cuando al pasar yo te vi. Salías del templo un día llorona cuando al pasar yo te vi. Hermoso pipil llevabas llorona que la.
Lila Downs singing in the film Frida about Frida Kahlo, the great Mexican artist. This is Democracy Now!, and Lila Downs is our guest. She's performing throughout the United States, though she lives in Oaxaca with her husband and her child. Speaking of history, you write about history, you write about politics, your songs. Can you tell us about San Juarez and who Juarez was?
Yeah. Well, Benito Juarez was the first Native American president in the 1800s on this continent, in Mexico. He was a lawyer, and he first became governor of Oaxaca. And then during Mexico's independence, he opted to actually befriend the United States, which was kind of in its upheaval at that point in time, and decided to cut off France and Spain. And so there are a lot of critics of Benito Juarez, but in Oaxaca, he's kind of a saint. And I think that he, like my mother says, you know, we have to put him on the altar on the Day of the Dead because he has to, you know, put in a good word for us with the saints and with the spirits. And he's also someone who I think that we see in him ourselves. So even though he may have, you know, critics as a lawyer, I think that the fact that he is a Zapotec Indian makes him someone that we really relate to, and we think to ourselves, okay, do we have to really change who we are in order to govern and to become a legitimate and dignified human being? No, we can coexist with this Western reality.
Let's go to Son Juarez from Lila Downs' latest album, Salón, Lágrimas y Deseo.
En mi memoria, el tiempo corre. Soy el aroma de cedro y de copal. Sagrado mi derecho de pensar.
Quiero contigo que importan más. Mirar al cerro con este cielo, porque las nubes son donde sueño para vivir. La vida es bella y en mi memoria hay tantas cosas que cambian todo sabiendo amar. Te busco en todo y en cada estrella. Me sabe la vida tomar tu mano, doy vuelta al sol.
Es un retrato Benito Juárez, es el hermano de Guelatao.
That's Son Juarez from Lila Downs' latest album. You talk about Juarez being an indigenous president.
Yes.
Now an indigenous woman is running for president of the United
States, right.
President of Mexico.
Of Mexico.
First time in, what, 145 years after
yes.
Son Juarez.
Yes.
Her name is Marichuy Maria de Jesus mm-hmm. Patricio.
Mm-hmm. Marichuy. She's a healer.
From Jalisco.
Yeah. From Jalisco, yeah. And she's a native woman. And she's also one of the interesting things about her platform and her vision, I think, is that she respects usos y costumbres, which is the native system of government and politics. And I think, you know, my husband says, oh, well, you know, she's going to divide the leftist vote, which probably is going to happen. But you know, I do think that it's important for a woman to speak of and to teach people, because people are very ignorant about what indigenous politics mean.
Can you talk about your song, Envidia?
Yes. Envidia is a song that we dedicate to the haters. Envidia, tú me tienes mucha envidia. You have so much envy of me. You wish you could be what I am, all of what I am. I mention Lakota, Mapuche, Azteca, Inca, Maya. Our inheritance is our pride. And yes, maybe youth might think that the world will end, but we will not permit that to happen. I am the tears in these stones beneath us, and I will continue to sing this rhythm to the Mother Earth.
Let's go to Envidia, the song on Lila Downs' 10th album that's just come out.
So this one is dedicated to the haters.
Ya no me tapas esta vez, ya somos muchos, porque yo tengo lo que tú quisieras ser. Ya no me tienes, soy debajo y escondida. Ya no me insultas porque tienes el poder. Ya no me escondes en el closet de tu casa. Que no te debo muchas horas de placer. Es más, tú sí me debes. Todos mis años, mis mejores, me quitaste. ¿Dónde se fueron? ¿Dónde se fueron nuestros sueños del ayer? Y
muriéndome por ti. Ya no seré la que se agacha y se calla. A mí se me respeta Lakota, Inca, Azteca, Mapuche, Maya. Mi herencia es una advertencia. El mundo no se acaba porque yo no lo permito. Yo soy las lágrimas en esta piedra y danzaré este ritmo a la madre tierra. Una afrenta y para nada no te debo yo y a ti. Si sabes bien y ya me conoces, ¿pa' qué me invitas a tu fiesta de infeliz? Ya no me compras porque aquí bonito cuesta, que no me vendo con infames como tú. Es más, tú sí me debes. Todos mis años, mis mejores me robaste. ¿Dónde se fueron nuestros sueños del ayer? Envidia, tú me tienes mucha envidia, porque soy todas las cosas que tú quieres para ti. Envidia, es que me tienes envidia. Viste, la vida sonríe y mi corazón es feliz. Corazón es feliz.
Envidia, from the 10th album of Lila Downs, performed by Lila Downs in the studios of Democracy Now. Lila, can you just comment on music as a form of resistance?
I think that I came to a crossroads at one point in my life when I was probably like almost 20 years ago. and I do remember in my previous life as a singer, I invited my mother to my first recital in Mexico, in Oaxaca. And my mom was there, you know, and my dad had just passed. I was 16. And so we had a broken heart. We were very sad. So we finished the recital. I sang some Bach. I sang, Ave Maria. I sang some arias from, I think it was La Banera from Carmen. And so my mother says, "Oh, yes, hija, very good. You sing very beautiful. But you know what? You're not feeling your songs. You have to have sentimiento." Wow. You know, that was my big lesson on delivering, you know, as we say in the U.S., delivering the goods. And I think that it came at that point in my life. So later on, even though I kept studying voice, I always loved singing, I thought, no, it's not enough to just sing a beautiful song. It has to connect in here. Maybe a little bit up here, and sometimes below the waist as well, which is really important. And, you know, I married a circus clown and saxophone player. And so I love the entertainment side of music. But I really do think it's about conviction. And I think that I have been saved by certain music. I have been saved by Mercedes Sosa. I have been saved by Lucha Reyes. I have been saved by Chavela Vargas at very dark moments in my life. So I believe that songs with conviction are necessary, and certainly at certain points in history.
What was it like to win your first Grammy? You won three Latin American Grammys and North American Grammy as well. What did that mean for your career and for more people knowing your work?
Yeah. Well, you know, I think at first when someone honors you, you are grateful. But I think one of the main lessons is in my life, and my Native American grandmother always taught me to be humble. And I think there's a great lesson in that. I think it's an interesting balance between being humble and being proud. I think you need to get legitimation sometimes from your culture, your people, your musical family. It's important for our people right now. But I also always stay humble. I always believe I am only an ant in this beautiful anthill called life.
Lila Downs, her 10th album is called Salon, Lágrimas y Deseo. This is Democracy Now! The album is dedicated to strong women everywhere. I'm Amy Goodman. Thanks so much for joining us.
Con mi dolor, causando penas, voy vagando por ahí. No hay una frase de cariño para mí. Todos me miran con desprecio y con rencor. Mi corazón está cansado, muy cansado de sufrir. Que muchas veces le he escuchado repetir estas palabras que me llenan de dolor. Urge una persona que me arrulle entre sus brazos, a quien contarle de mis triunfos y fracasos, que me consuele y que me quite de sufrir. Urge que me despierten con un beso enamorado, que me devuelvan el amor que me han negado, porque también tengo derecho de vivir. Urge una persona que me arrulle entre sus brazos, a quien contarle de mis triunfos y fracasos, que me consuele, to help me stop suffering. Fracasos, que me consuele y que me quite de sufrir.